Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we are going to do a practice test, and first practice test that we will do is about reading. So first of all, we will read passage and then we will solve questions. Okay, so the first passage is about undersea water. So undersea water, it has basically 8 paragraphs, approximately 8 paragraphs, and the first paragraph is: the underwater world holds many challenges. The most basic of these is movement. The density of water makes it difficult for animals to move. Forward movement is a complex interaction of underwater forces. Additionally, water itself has movement. Strong currents carry incredible power that can easily sweep creatures away. The challenges to aquatic movement result in a variety of swimming methods used by a wide range of animals. So as you can see in this video, I have shown the very first paragraph. You can read this. First of all, you can read, you will read all these paragraphs, and then you will solve questions that is on the other side. First of all, you will read all these paragraphs attentively. So you can see there is no specific topic, different topics are incorporated. As you can see in the reading portion of IELTS, you can see many different topics, such as the one that I am showing right now, that is undersea movement. Next line is the result is a dazzling underwater ballad. Now the next paragraph is, just keep in your mind, you do not have much time, just read it as fast as you can. Okay, next paragraph is, fish rely on their skeleton, fins and muscles to move. The primary function of the skeleton is to add movement of other parts. Their skin acts as a fulcrum and their vertebrae acts as levers. The vertebral column consists of a series of vertebrae held together by ligaments, but not so tightly as to prevent slight sideways movement between each pair of vertebrae. The whole spine is therefore flexible. The scale is the only truly fixed part of a fish. It does not move in and of itself, but acts as a point of stability for other bones. These other bones act as levers that cause movement of fish's body. So you can see. So guys, what you can do is pause this video and read each paragraph attentively and take some time, because this is your first practice test. So take time, read each paragraph attentively, and then try to solve the questions. And when you solve the questions, write the answers in the comment box, and I will reply either you are wrong or either you are right. This is how you can do practice. Now we will see the last paragraph, that is 8. One type of shellfish is considered to be the fastest species of fish over short distances, achieving 68 mph over a 3-second period, and elsewhere have recorded speed in excess of 40 mph over longer periods. For several species of tuna, one is likely to consider a fish's swimming capabilities in relation to its size. However, it is generally true that a small fish is a more able swimmer than a much larger one. On the other hand, in terms of speed in miles per hour, a big fish will, all other things being equal, be able to swim faster than a smaller fish. So you can see in the each paragraph that they have given some information, and you just have to keep in this thing in your mind, that in which paragraph which information they have given. Because if we see the first question, you can see they have given us questions such as in which paragraph they have given which sort of information. So they have given a line from different paragraphs, and they want us to tell us in which paragraph they have given that information. So this is how they are asking the first question. So read all the paragraphs attentively. and try to absorb all the information and try to keep all the information in your mind, that in which paragraph, which information, what information they have given. This is how you can solve your first question. And in your second question, they have shown a diagram. You can read that diagram and you can see the question, and then you can solve the question. Now you can see the third question, that is complete the summary below using no more than 3 words. So they have given a paragraph and they want you to write few words, no more than 3 words, few words, I mean 1 or 2 words, and complete the sentence and complete the summary. So this is how you are going to answer the reading portion. So if you like my video, kindly subscribe my channel and like this video and share this video, because from now I'm going to share different practice tests with you, and we will practice it together. And don't forget to write all the answers that you think right according to you, that are right, in the comment section, and I'll reply that either you are right or wrong. Thank you so much for watching.